Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hey, in this video, we're going to take our website, which currently stretches on to infinity, and we are going to do this to it, where it's now all centered and only has a maximum width of about 1200 pixels. And when I resize it, it's always in the center. So let's go and do that now using Adobe Dreamweaver. Okay, so currently if I preview in a browser, this thing, my header goes on forever. What I'd like it to do is kind of stick here in the middle when it gets to a certain width, okay, a max width of about 1200 pixels. Otherwise, it looks fine on my laptop here, but if you're on a like a really big screen like an iMac, and one of the big 27-inch guys, you're going to have your logo on this side and your navigation is going to be like a kilometer to the right over this side. So we need some sort of like maximum boundaries, and we want it to be centered left and right. So we're going to do it in Dreamweaver using a container. It's pretty easy. So back to Dreamweaver. So here in Dreamweaver, I need to wrap everything that I can see on my page in a container. This includes my header at the moment, and that's about it. So the body is everything I see on the page. So I want the header down here. Okay, so I want all of this to be inside a container that I can center. Then the header will come along for the ride. I'll put the whole website inside this container. To do it, over here in my live view, okay, just click on your header. Want to see this header here? If you find you're clicking on the image and you can't really find it, what you can do, see down here, this is called your tag selector. So I've got my image selected, there it is there. And there's an A tag around it, and then there's a header around that, and there's a body around that. So this is a good way to kind of select on these things. Click on the header, or just click over here on this side. And we are going to go to insert, and under HTML, we're gonna do this thing called a div. Divs are super common in web design. They are divisions of space. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on this and we're gonna get these options here. Okay, so what it's asking me is, do I want this div to be placed before the thing I've got selected, which is a header? Do I want it after it? Do I wanna wrap it around? Okay, so wrap it around the outside, or do I wanna nest it, which means do I wanna jam it inside the header? Okay, like our images. So in our case is wrap. Okay, I've got the header selected. I would like this container to wrap around the outside so that the header is inside. So let's click wrap. And it's probably best to see down here in code view, you can see this div is wrapped around the header. Awesome. Now div is a real generic name for container. Okay, and we're gonna use lots of div tags throughout the site. So we need to give it a name so that we can tell it to do a specific thing. Because if I say div, I want you to be centered, every single div in this whole website is gonna be centered, and that's not gonna be what we want. So what we do is two parts. We defined the name over here and what it does, and then we're going to apply it here in live view. So to define the name, we do it over here in my CSS designer panel. We click on styles, we say I'd like it in global, and we're going to give it a name. See what it says selector? Click the plus button. Now up until now, we've defined things that already exist in our HTML. Okay, you can see here we defined header. You can see here it wants to define the body, so things that already exist. What I'd like to do is give this a brand new name, one that doesn't exist on the page now, a really unique name. Because if I started styling the div, remember it's going to apply to all of them. And the way we make these unique is we add a name to them, okay? And these are called classes. Think a class selector is just a name that I'm giving it, okay? And the way you define classes is you put a full stop or a period at the beginning of your name. That tells the internet this is something specific that I've made up. And I'm going to call mine container. You could call it anything. You could call it banana sandwich, and it would still work, okay? We're just calling ours container. If you're gonna use banana sandwich, you can't use spaces, okay? You need to make sure if you're gonna do banana sandwich, you have to use a space sandwich. And then you'd have to explain to whoever works on your website next why you called your container banana sandwich. But anyway, so we're giving it a name, make sure it's got a full stop at the beginning, give it a name, use lowercase. Most of the time it'll work with uppers and lowers, but don't, okay? And now over here, you see where it says show set? We're going to turn that off. We had that on in an earlier tutorial. Okay, it showed you everything that's applied to this container so far, and there's nothing. Okay, so we're going to untick it so we can see them all. So the first thing we're going to do to center our website is we're going to give ours a maximum width. We're going to say, instead of getting as big as you like forever, We're going to say I'd like a maximum width, and we're actually going to match what we did here in Illustrator. In Illustrator, what did we decide? Where's my layers, my outboards? We decided that our biggest width we've designed for is 1200 pixels. Now, this is not an absolute specific size it needs to be. You might be working to 1024, which was a really common size. 1200 is more common now. This keeps changing, okay, and really depends on what you want the biggest size to be. Follow me, do 1200, works fine. Smallest for the biggest size you need to be is probably 1024 or 1024. Don't go any smaller than that. So jump back into Dreamweaver. So what I want to say is you can get to a max width of pixels and you can only be 1200 wide. For some reason, Dreamweaver at the moment double types a lot of my letters. You'll see this throughout this course. I can't make it stop. Anyway, so 1200 pixels is how wide it's going to be. I'm going to preview in a browser. And when I stretch it out, I'm going to move it over here and stretch it out. Prepare yourself for, it doesn't work. Why? It's because we've created it in Dreamweaver, but we haven't applied it yet. So let's go into Dreamweaver. What I mean by that is we've created it down here. We've styled it and we said bare max width, but over here we haven't actually applied it to my div. So we need to add it to it. So what you need to do is select the div. So if you can't select it and say you've got this clicked, remember the tag selected down here is really handy. I'm gonna grab the div and here, okay, you can add a class or an ID and we're gonna type in our class. Now what goes at the beginning of a class? That's right, a period or a full stop. And you can see there, because Dreamweaver is super helpful, it's actually added the word container there for me. I could type it in, okay, but it's pre-selected it for me. Hit return, and now I'm gonna go preview in a browser. What I'm first gonna do is do the save all, cool little shortcut, remember. Otherwise, file, save all. Okay, now we're gonna check it in a browser. Hey, so now that div called container says don't be anything bigger than 1200. The reason I say don't be anything bigger is because I actually want it to be smaller, okay? Because we're gonna get down to tablet and mobile stuff. So instead of just using width, okay, use max width. So go no more than that, but underneath that, do what you want. So our next problem is it's not centered, okay? So it's doing the right width, but it's not kind of centering on my page. And I don't know, we went through a transformation in web design where everyone wanted it left, nobody wanted it right, and then everyone wants it centered now. So let's go and do that. To do it, it's pretty easy. So make sure styles.css, global, make sure your container selected. And all you do under margin, okay, is where it says this little pixels, switch that to auto, pixels, auto. So you make left and right margins auto, hit save all, check it in the browser. And hey, we have got a centered website. So as long as everything goes inside that container div, it will then get centered, okay, like this. So let's jump back in. So that's gonna be it for centering our website. We are now gonna go off and create some media queries, because at the moment we have a max width for kind of like desktop view. I would like to do some changes and add some media queries for tablet and mobile. This is what we consider responsive web design. Let's go and do it in the next video. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.